The Edsel is very subjective, and there's no middle of the road. People either really love it or really hate it, and it's been that way since the day they came out. My dad was one of the ones that didn't like it, which is why we didn't get a new one. I loved it. I had the scale models when they were little, and my first car was an Edsel. This is our 52nd annual convention. We have met annually every year since 1969, and we move the convention around the country, so it gives all members all over the country and Canada and the world a chance to come. We have members that come from Sweden, the United Kingdom. It's a great family event, and literally this is a family reunion. Most of us have known each other for 52 years, if we're old enough. I think in the early days, when we first started the club, the Edsel was such a laughing stock because they were only 10 years old. And I bet half of our members were original owners who thought, finally, somebody appreciates that I've kept my Edsel in really nice condition. Today, we've got a lot of younger people in their 20s who just think they're a really cool old 50s car, not knowing any of the story about what a sales disaster was. They just think it's a beautiful 50s cruiser. The Edsel came out in the middle of a short, sharp recession in the fall of 57, where all medium-priced car sales just tanked. The Edsel was a brand new make. It wasn't selling anywhere near where they thought it was going to sell, and it became a laughing stock. And a lot of people thought the vertical grille in the front was a little different looking. I bought my first Edsel in 1967. It was a top-of-the-line 58 Citation 4-door hardtop, and I paid $120 for it.